Hello, Dark Souls 2. Oh baby, fucking love this game. Love it. Far my favourite out of Bloodborne, Dark Souls 2, Dark Souls 1. Yeah, I think it's absolutely brilliant. So this is PlayStation 4, Skull of the First Sin. So what we're going to do is going to do basically like an edited walkthrough. What I mean by that is I'm not going to do a full walkthrough. I'm just going to do basically like I did with Bloodborne, the combat tips and the boss battles, but I'll be doing that all in one. So, like the decent people to fight, I'll be covering, and the boss fighters, I'll be covering, okay? But you know, normal things, like going through this bit, and like that, I won't be doing that. Okay, so, whoop! Gonna look forward to it. Shut up. Hello! Right, so, I'm going to cover this area first, alright? So what I've decided to go with is, let's have a look at my stats here. It's level 14, I haven't leveled up at all. I went for the Cleric, I think it's called. The main reason why I went with it is because doing this lit area first, the mace, that's the prime reason, the mace absolutely wrecks these knights. So let's have a look, it's not upgraded at all. See what I mean? So, four hits. Four hits, and he's down. And so, yeah, you get anything else, any other weapons really, are not upgraded in this area, and you're going to get your ship pissed in. So, that's why I picked that one, and I'm going here first. I'm going to concentrate primarily on strength. Strength build. The last one missing. God. That was sloppy. Heal me. Fucking slow. Yeah. So I'm going to concentrate primarily on a strength build. Basically getting the great sword, the ultra great sword. And then later on my main weapon, one of my favourite weapons will be, it's a long way, but it's going to be the red iron twin blade. So they primarily have like a three hit combo. Can you see the dragon rider there? You can't you? Already. I don't think you can see him. Yeah. I don't know if that's new. I'm sure you can see him before. Anyway. Wait. Hey! Facing this fella then. Hello. Hey. One. Two, maybe three, because he's got less life. Over here, the other one will calm down. Let him just do three, two, three. Yep. There you go. Press this down. I mean, some people, I've got the skill that they can basically make the dragon rider fall off by not activating those two, because what happens there is that you're basically bringing the level up when you face the dragon rider, so you can't fall off. But some people don't even bother doing it, like on speed runs and stuff like that, so that he then thrusts and falls off. Better dodging this time against him. Pretty quite hard early on, I suppose. Oh, this is early on. Okay, so Dragon Rider. Let's give it a go. Basically, you know, just concentrate on being on his shield side. Look at my positioning if you're going to take anything from it. Concentrate on his stamina even more so than Dark Souls, for example. Bloodborne, more forgiving in it with your stamina, like with mine. You know, two hits with this and done, for the amount that I start off with. So I just want to make sure I can't really do a three, because I always want to make sure that I've got stuff a little bit left to dodge with that. time. You're doing good damage to him because of this mace. One more hit should do it. There we go. I don't know which one of these. Or maybe that one. Shut up. Yeah, that'll do. Because I don't think there is a one when he puts it to his lips. Which I'm a little bit devastated about. But yeah, there we go. So that's that been done. Little tip with this girl then. A little bit of light that at first, just in case your girl sits up. But yeah, best to kill her. Unless you're a faith build, maybe keep her alive then. She's got some good miracles to buy, but I don't need it. So I need her key, because otherwise she charges me. Is it like 2 grand? Oh. So I'm just going to punch her off the edge. That doesn't kill her. So wait for her to come up here. Make sure you do this properly, because she fucking hits hard. There we go. 2,500 extra souls, which is much appreciated in this early stage. And there's the key. Happy days. See you, love. Okay, Giantoid. Next. I was open to, like, absolutely smashing with my, where is it? With my great sword that I picked up. Oh, I can use that. Cool, I'll use that. That'll fucking take care of it. Yeah, it looks better for it. But I did want to use that on him. But I used all my points to get my strength up 30. Not knowing that I needed 10 dex to do it, so... So this is where we're at the moment. I've whacked basically everything in strength. His strength is fucking high there, 30. And a couple into dex trying to get up with it, but... oh well. Cool, I got this bandic axe, so this will make short work of him. Nice one. Hello! Hello, last Giantoid. On the PlayStation, it makes me watch these for the first time, which is interesting. All these cutscenes is making me watch. Alright, come on. Okay, so I'm just going to run through his legs to begin with while he attacks. And then to take it easy, a couple of hits on his leg, making sure he doesn't stamp on me. Fucking hell, first time I played this and I thought, that's the first boss. I was like, what the fuck is this game? Oh shit. He's having a tantrum. 1, 2, didn't do much damage. Getting friendly. That was a bit weird. Rip your own arm off. That's a good idea. Why not? And... Hey, guy! Giant! Shut up! There you go. He is the first boss, so after all. Stupid, though, isn't it? How is he, a giant, the first boss? I just don't get it. I don't get it. How is he the first boss? Why didn't you just have something little? I don't know. Anyway, there we go. Giant done. Alright. Okay, I got my sword, bitches. Right, so let's have a look. Level 42, 12 vigor, only 5 endurance. Need to get that up. Vitality 8, attunement 10, strength 30, dex 10, 4, 12. Okay. So, I'm going to go and face this... boss next. Is this Sextile Sensory? So we're gonna I've already done the shortcut, but we'll do I'll show the build up to it, because there is a couple of original enemies on this part, isn't it? These guys, I must admit, they're no joke. These are no joke in themselves. You get caught up in a combo, especially by fucking Scimitar fella at the back there, and he can one shot you if you haven't put your vigor up enough. I mean, my vigor's again, not that high, because I've been turn it into strength primarily so I can just wield this bad boy as soon as possible, but yeah, give them respect. Jeez, I mean, like, have a spear, a double-handed spear, keep them at bay. As they hit, oh, that combo's deadly. It really is. I see you there, sir. Get down. And you. No! Hit you. Kill you one shot. Yeah, so I've managed to, just through the path I know on the way to the giant and stuff like that, managed to get the great sword up to +3 already. So 260 plus 81. I mean, fuck me, it's a beast. Just a good weapon to go to the game. Okay, yeah, so we might as well cover these guys as well. Because these are the original to this area. I don't. There's one later on of the kingdom. You'll see it, but fucking hell, Bloodborne, Jesus. Why I'm saying that is I wanted to two-hand it, which is L1, but on this it's triangle. So just let them do that two attack, and then this is why it's good as well. I can hit two at a time. They do bleeding damage, and they really do hurt. And just like typical, you know, Dark Souls kind of cheapness is that when you get in one, you think the other one's behind. You think, oh yeah, he's behind, so no dramas. I can just get fucking deal with him. Nope. He'll hit right through him and fuck up your day. There's loads of them more up there anyway, but yeah, let them do that two attack. They're quite easy to backstab if you shield it and then look for a backstab. They do hit hard, remember that, they fucking hit really hard. The early game. And you will fucking try and gang rape you. See again, this guy, respect him. Try and just get it right. Concentrate on him. Don't think, oh, who the fuck are you? No, I've died many times to these guys. Fucking hell. See, with Bloodborne, I didn't attack for a while then, so I thought, you know, I'd be alright. You know, I could adapt back to Souls. Especially with a big weapon like this, you know, I'm going to be using my stamina, and it's not going to regenerate as quick as on Bloodborne. 1, 2, get out of there. One more should do it. Yeah, there we go. Flexile Sentry coming up then. Hopefully with this weapon we should make fucking mincemeat out of him. Just to make sure, because we're in water, I think he's susceptible to... Oh, I haven't got it yet. I forgot to say he's susceptible to thunder, lightning, whatever, but we'll put this on anyway, we got it. Buff it a bit, like. There we go, let's see how we get on. I want the club person primarily. I want him to be the aggressor. Club boy, him. Easy to dodge. 1, 2. Look at that damage, guys. Right, watch my stamina. My stamina's still not there. Fuck. Don't rely on that pillar as well. They cheat you through it. Just gonna do one here, and then get out of there. Doing enough damage, don't need to be greedy, do we? 1. Want the club guy to be the aggressor. Easier to dodge. Back up. And finish him. Boom! See ya! Shut up. Here we go. Beautiful damage. Oh, love it. Next box completed. Hello. Right, pursuer. We're going to do the pursuing next, mate. Fucking wank is really disappointed. Right, so vigor 20. It's level 52. Vigor 20. Endurance 7. You can read it yourself there, okay? So, leveled up a little bit. Great sword is now +5, 300 points +93. Oh yeah. Right, how many throwing knives have I got to get rid of this fuck face? Ah, that's it, so I need 3. I only need 2, so let's make sure they count. Oops. No. Fucking, can I still, yeah. That's for you, mate. That's for you, you dick. I hate him. I fucking hate those knobheads because they got a shield, right? But they can block with the shield without blocking, if you know what I mean. They just walk towards you and you hit the shield like, and they didn't even bring it up. Fucking lazy cunts. Okay. Alright, these guys, right? Early on in the game, this is how I beat them anyway. So with the mace in particular, it fucking got me. Just let him do that to himself, but anyway, just judge whatever attack he's going to do like that, and then jump and attack, and then I would go out. And I'd let him swing to the side, hit the floor, and then I'm going to hit him again. That's how I beat him anyway. Okay, pursuer. I'm going to beat him up here, because there's more room. And it's more challenging, because otherwise you get tempted to use the massive crossbows, whatever they're called. I can't remember what they're called. Right? So yeah. Right, I'm just going to roll to the side of his shield. Simple as. I'll hit him once. Hit him once. And then I'm going to back up. One, two, three. Three combo. Hit him once. Back up. One, two, three. Alright, remember they're delayed. Okay, the curse attacks are slow, don't let him hit you one attack. I'm gonna let him hit me because I need to actually get my stamina anyway. Hey! Oosh! One, two, three. Hey! Oosh! Running attack, just go towards the shield. I'm gonna do two, finish one. See ya! Oh, then these little bitches come. You see what I did to him, boys? Did you see it? You think you can stand a chance? No, you can't! Fuck off, cheap wankers. Heal me! Drink the Estus. Miss that. Fucking blood files. I can fucking suck a dick. There you go. And he's pretty easy then, isn't he? Just, roll away. Estus flash shard up there as well. So, and I will have that ring. Thank you very much. Nice one. Pursuer. Done. Okay. Ruined Sentinels next. They're on this part. Fucking hell, when I first faced these guys. When I was a Dark Souls noob. Fucking not sure how that's happened. Never mind. Yeah, when I was a Dark Souls noob, these guys gave me a lot of problems, but now they're quite easy, he says, but yeah, I find them quite easy, so. Right. Pursue again. Yeah, what? Am I over encumbered? This could be a bit. Yeah, I'm put a ring on. Put a should be alright though. I'll let them have those. Okay. Yeah, that's exactly the move I wanted. Oh, that is horrible. Right, come on, hit him once, please. Fucking hell. Sake. That was rookie-esque, wasn't it, eh? The fuck? Yep, just over because of the because of that ring that I just put on. Leave that off on there. And just use two flasks that I'm gonna need for the for the bosses. Never mind, doesn't matter. Should be alright. The way with the damage that we're doing it should be fine. Right, so okay, these guys. Check for the pyromancy. That's the time to attack. Two hits a bit. Good, two hits every day. Good for me. Come on in. Roll you open. I already spoke to Luke Teal. I did this bit after I faced the Ruined Sentinel or whatever he's called. I will go down here because I need to open to gain access to the blacksmith. So you got to do it this way. So what I recommend is with this barrel, just go past him and just kind of run it down. Sorry, I can't see it. That didn't explode. Have I got, I've got a fire bomb or something, have I? Oh yeah, I've got three, thank fuck for that. Put it there. Should be right where it is. Hello! Explode, you! Two for one! Light you! Come over here, you knob. Right, don't need you to. I think they're quite susceptible to lightning. There you go, one. Those things on this, fucking hell. Make sure you try and buy them before they get more expensive. Every time you beat a, you know, what are they called? Like an ultra boss, or what are they called again? I don't know. But you know, like the witch woman with the mask, whatever she's fucking called. She's one, and then the big lava guy, he's another. It's like every time you beat someone like that, the big fucking guy is it. I don't know their names at all, it's a shaggy. But like, there's the spider, the big pile of fucking guts, like that thing with the butcher's knife, he's one. The witch with the mask, she's one. And then the big fuck off lava guy, not the thingy demon, smelter demon, the big guy. So every time you beat one of them, you know, it doesn't matter what order you do, those bright bugs go up in price quite dramatically. So they're only, there were 6,000, you know, without beating any of them. I think they, and then I think they got to 12,000, and so. And they're basically, they increase your damage and increase your defense. They're fucking really, really good. So I keep them. I buy them as much as I can now. I don't really need them for these bosses, but for like the fume knights and stuff like that later on, I will need them. They'd really come in handy. Can't use them though if you're doing co-op. If you summon someone, or you're doing co-op, if you summon a NPC to help you, then you can't use them. I hate that. Fucking hate that. Because how often do you see the fucking enemy hit the wall and suddenly stagger himself? Never! That's the answer. For me, I fucking do it like a bitch. See, if I summoned her, I wouldn't be able to use it, but I'm not going to use it. I should do enough damage to these Ruined Sentinels anyway. Is it Ruined Sentinels? I don't know. Oh, that's the name of the thing I've already defeated. Look at that though, look how big that range is. Fucking beautiful, isn't it? And the stagger, fuck me. The damage. Right, so I'm just going to want to basically do it one-on-one with Matey Boy up here. Triangle, isn't it? A fucking triangle to do that. One-on-one with Matey Boy up here. And then when the other guys come, I'm going to buff, do as much damage to him as I can when he jumps up. You'll see, before we face him 2-on-1. Look at this damage. Beautiful. Boop. Just do one there. Don't want to get knocked off, guys. You get knocked off, this fight is basically 3-on-1 then it's not fun. It's about learning those patterns, learning where to stand. I mean, I faced these guys a million times before. So what I'm preferably wanting to do now is beating this guy if I can before his mate comes up here. So a bit of a race against time, but we'll see how we get on. Nope. Die then. But nah, that's okay. Oh no, it's not. I hope this doesn't kill me. No, it doesn't. One, two, beautiful. Oh, someone hasn't got this shield anymore though. Jeez. Make sure you don't watch out for this jump and attack. It's 2-on-1 again. fucking different kind of fish, innit? Right, so I want to stay on him because he's almost dead. One more hit should do it. There we go. Now we're back in the game. Got a little bit fucking worried there. Fuck, no. Uh-oh. Stamina management. Uh-oh. Oh. Come on, just use another one. Should be able to get two here. There we go. Fucking hell. Sorry, I was pretty sloppy. I was sloppy, wasn't it? It's just, I didn't want that guy to fall off, and then he fell off. And I thought where I was standing when he jumped up, he wouldn't be able to hit me, but he did hit me, and then fucking hell, I was like, oh shit. I'm going to get my bearings then, but, you know, got there in the end, sloppy.